Hey guys, welcome back to this brand new After Effects tutorial. In this tutorial, I am going to create a very nice and simple historic slideshow animation inside of After Effects in a few simple steps that you can call it paper burn effect as well. So my name is Vikas, and without any further ado, let's jump into the After Effects and get started. Alright, so if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more interesting videos, and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition, so let's call it main. So the size of this composition 1920 by 1080, let's go with any frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second, which is a normal frame rate, and I'm gonna set the duration of this composition maybe 6 seconds long and hit OK. Now let's create one more composition. So just go to this composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be our media composition where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So I'm going to call it media, set it 1920 by 1080 frame rate, 30 duration, make it 6 seconds long and hit OK. Now I'm going to import an image or video file for this project. So just go to this project window, right click on that, go to import file, and in this case I'm using this image, and click on import. Now let's import this image into this media composition, and then go to your main composition. Alright, and after that we need some asset for this project. So just go to this project window again, right click on that, go to import file, and in this case I'm using this video clip and this paper texture, and click on import. Now let's import this paper texture into this main composition, and as you can see it's looking like this, but you can use any different paper texture that you like. And now let's import one more composition. So just go to this composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be our burn effect, so let's call it burn effect, hit OK. Now let's import this burn video clip into this burn effect. And as you can see, we have something like this, and I have given a link in the description. So just go to the link and download these assets if you want, and just go to 2.5 seconds right over here, and I'm gonna add a cut. So select this burn video clip, hold Control Shift and press D on the keyboard, go to 1 second forward in time right over here maybe, and hit Control Shift D and split the layer again, select this top layer, hit delete button. All right now just right click on this second clip and go to time stretch, and I'm gonna set this a stretch factor value maybe 360 and hit OK. Now it's looking much more interesting, as you can see. Now just go to your main composition, and here we have to import this burn effect composition into this main composition, and here I want this white section black and this black section white. So just go to effect and preset. If you can't see this effect and preset, then go to window and check this option effect and preset and search for invert. So this is our invert effect. Let's apply this on video clip, and now it's looking perfect. And after that we have to make this white section transparent. So what we have to do, just go to blending mode. If you can't see this blending mode, then click on this toggle switches and change this blending mode to multiply. And now we have this paper texture as well, as you can see. And after that we have to import our media composition. So just drag this media composition into this main composition, and now let's make it black and white. So just go to effect and preset and search for tint. Let's apply this tint on this image and make it black and white. And after that we have to add one more effect. So just select this media composition, go to effect, go to noise and grain, and here we have this add grain. So click on this add grain effect, and now we have to increase the intensity. So I'm gonna set this value maybe 4 or 5, and I want black and white grain. So just go to color and check this option monochromatic, and we don't need any animation on this grain. So open this animation and set this animation speed 0. and just go to viewing mode and set it to final output. After that, we have to animate this media composition. So hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Hit Shift on the keyboard and hit R to open a rotation also. And go to the end of this animation. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale, and click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on rotation as well. And go to very first frame of this animation and set this scale value maybe 120%, and let's set this rotation value negative 10 degree. And after that, let's close this layer, and now we have nice and simple animation as you can see. And after that, I'm going to use this burn effect as a matte for this image. So what we have to do, just go to this project window and let's import this burn effect again into this main composition. Right click on that, click on rename, call it burn effect 02. And for this time, I'm going to make this black portion transparent. So what we have to do, just select this burn effect, go to effect, go to keying, and here we have this linear color key. So I'm going to apply this linear color key and pick this color picker and pick this black color and make it transparent. And here we have this matching softness, so I'm going to set this value maybe 100%. All right, and now we have something like this, and I'm going to use this white section as a matte for this image. So what we have to do, just select this media composition, just go to track matte. If you can't see this track matte, then click on this toggle switches and change this to alpha matte. All right, and we will get this type of effect. And after that, select this media composition and this burn effect 02, just go to half a second from beginning of this animation and just drag this both layer right over here. And now we have something like this, and it's looking much more interesting. And after that, we have to create a text over here. So select this text tool, go to character. So if you don't have this character, then go to window and check this option character, and let's select a font style. So in this case, I'm using this Callisto MT font style. Set it to bold, and I'm going to set this font size something around 75 pixel. Click over here and type anything that you want. Now I'm going to select this bottom line. I'm going to increase the size of this font, so I'm going to set it to 100 pixel, and just select this text layer, select this move tool, and just place this text right over here maybe. And after that, just go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. So this is a drop shadow effect. Let's apply this on text layer and let's do some basic settings. So I'm going to set this softness value maybe 25 or 30, and after that I'm going to animate this text. So open this text layer, click on this animate, go to opacity, set this opacity 0%, go to on 1 second maybe, open this range selector, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a start parameter, and go to on 3 second, set this start value 100%. And now we have this typing kind of an effect. All right, and close this text layer, and I'm gonna drag this text layer on 1 second, just like this. And after that, just go to layer, go to new and take a new adjustment layer, and right click on that, click on rename, and let's call it color, and go to effect and preset and search for curves. Let's apply these curves on this adjustment layer, and just go to this channel and change this to blue, and let's set this graph just like this. All right, and after that, just select all the layers, right click on that, click on this pre-compose, and let's call it animation. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And now let's create transition for this slideshow. So just go to half a second maybe on frame number 15, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position. Go to 15 frame back in time from the end of this animation right over here. Add one more keyframe and lock this value and just go to the end of this animation. Let's drag it and set this value something around 3000 and go to very first frame of this animation and let's drag it in negative. So I'm gonna set this Y value something around negative 2000 and we have something like this. But I want to fill this blank area. So what we have to do, just select this animation, go to effect and preset and search for motion tile. And just drag this motion tile on this animation layer. And here we have to set this output height maybe 600. And now we don't have any blank area. And let's do one more thing. I'm gonna merge these edges. So check this option, mirror edges, and now it's looking perfect. And after that, we have to add one more effect. So just search for directional blur. So this is our directional blur effect. Let's apply this on animation and just go to on half a second right over here. And click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on blur length. And just go to over here, maybe select this animation layer, hit U on the keyboard to open the active keyframe, and here this is the blur length. So click on this diamond button to add one more keyframe and go to the end of this animation and set this blur length value 100 and go to very first frame, set this blur length value 100. All right, and select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, and after that just select this animation, hit P on the keyboard, just select this position keyframe, go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and click on this editor speed graph and select this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Hold this handle also and just drag it like this and do the same thing for this one. So hold this handle and just drag it on right hand side and do the same thing for this one. Just drag it on right hand side and make this graph just like this and close this graph editor. Close this layer. Just go to very first frame, click on fit, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking nice and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon to get notified when I will upload my new video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.